In this video, you're going to learn how to create sacred space in your home. I'm Brianna Borton, and I help people awaken to their highest selves. Subscribe to my channel and hit that bell to get alerted when I post a new video every single Monday. So since my late teens, I've been obsessed with creating beautiful spaces that are healing and opening, starting with redesigning a hostel in the Czech Republic for our community there to be able to gather and relax, to founding and designing spas for optimal relaxation and healing, to making altars and spaces in my own home and homes of my clients and friends for their spiritual practices, to creating sacred spaces for the retreats that I lead. Most of us are hugely influenced by our physical surroundings. It can change our mood, it can open us up to something more than ourselves, it can be a deep and lasting healing when done beautifully. So this is why we go out into nature, is because it is like the most sacred of spaces and it gives us that sense of calm. And we can bring that into our homes and create these sacred spaces for ourselves. And I want to help you get started on creating your own sacred space for your spiritual expansion. So I've broken it down to 5 of the key elements to start with. The first thing to do is choose a space. It doesn't have to be a huge space. It doesn't have to be your whole house. It doesn't even have to be a whole room. You can start with just a corner of a room. I suggest making it a place that feels like you're honoring it though. You don't want to do it in like the back of your closet where you'll never see it. Make it a space where you'll see it when you wake up in the morning, or maybe a space where it's kind of the centerpiece of your home, whatever feels right to you. But I encourage you to choose a place that you'll see and a place that you'll feel like you're honoring. You can create an altar anywhere. And you may choose to have many little altars in your home, but we're gonna focus here on creating an altar or a sacred space for you to do your spiritual practice at. So once you've chosen your space, the next thing to do is to bring things in to the space that feed all your senses. So you may set up a table and cover it with a beautiful cloth. And then you want to make sure that you bring things in that feed those senses. So sound could be a bell or chimes, or it could be that you have some way of playing music there. Some way for you to have sound that feels relaxing, opening, and healing for you there. You'll also want to make sure that there is the sense of touch there, something that you can feel. So textures, and sometimes we actually feel things with our eyes. I know that that might sound a little weird, but textures are things that we may or may not actually touch, but that we feel in our touching sensation in a way. And so it could be soft things, it could be things that have a hard texture or a smooth texture, or it could be a variety of these things in order to kind of delight your senses in that way. You also want to bring in visual senses. And this seems maybe like the most obvious because it seems like the one that we're most aware of most of the time, but you'll want to bring in colors that make you feel relaxed and open that you may want to change with the seasons. You also might want to bring in things that are just beautiful to you that allows your sense of sight to feel opened, expanded, relaxed, honored, and loved. The third thing to do is to make it personal. What inspires you personally? These could be mementos, these could be talismans or art, your own art or other people's art. It could be photographs of loved ones or special places to you. It could be statues, traditional symbols of the divine and protective energies. These could be stones or crystals or shells from places or just ones that you think are beautiful. It could be candles or incense or mirrors or musical instruments or any other personal divination tools that you love, like the tarot or the I Ching. Could be sacred words or texts or poems like Hafiz or Rumi. These are all things that you could bring in to your sacred space, but I really want to encourage you to make sure that you have a connection with them, that this is personally inspiring for you. One thing that I've seen a lot is that people create their new sacred space and it doesn't feel personal. It doesn't feel like them. And I might even ask them, well, like, why do you have that statue? Or why do you have that imagery? And they're kind of like, oh, well, I don't know. It was just at the store, so I bought it. But the thing is that what makes it sacred is its specialness to you. So make sure that it feels really personal. The fourth thing is to bring in nature. So bring nature inside to your altar. And you might even decide that you want to bring in the elements. And so you might bring in crystals or stones. You might bring in sticks or leaves or plants. I have lots of plants by my altar, lots of sticks, lots of crystals, lots of beautiful things from nature that I bring in to just remind me of the importance of nature, the beauty, and they really do inspire me. You might choose to bring in objects to represent each of the elements. You might bring in a candle for fire, something for wood, something for earth and metal and water, whatever tradition speaks to you and maybe a tradition that has been brought through you in your life from your ancestors. It's really useful to know why, again, you're doing it so that it feels personal and specifically sacred to you. And then the fifth really important part of creating sacred space is to designate this space as sacred through use. So you could set up a really beautiful altar. It could have all of these elements to it. But if you don't sit down and do your daily practice at that altar, it's going to become very flat very quickly. We keep these spaces alive by committing to doing our daily practice in that space with clarity and intention and love. And so create the space as sacred through use. And once you have your space set up, do a ritual to open it up. Maybe you clear the energetic space, maybe you honor all of the directions or all of the elements, whatever feels right for you, do that and really honor the space that you're creating. I can't wait to see the space that you create. So when you do, take a picture of it and post it on social media and tag me at Brianna Borton with the hashtag sacred space so I can see your beautiful space you're creating. If you liked this video, hit like and be sure to subscribe and share it with your friends. And check out my other videos to create more peace and freedom in your life, like this video with a cosmic download you won't want to miss, and this video on taking your seat in the web of the universe. I'm sending you so much love.